everyone, welcome back to Fire Emblem Heroes. We are here with a new showcase, this time featuring the New Year's version of Regin. Regin is one of the princesses protagonist of the books, which are the main story of Fire Emblem Heroes. In this case, she is from Book 5. Regin is also a character that we have not seen before in showcases, actually, because I never found the time to do her original version. Maybe I will in the future. But I wanted to cover both her and in the future Plumeria, which I also got from the Gacha, as the new showcases for the upcoming weeks, at least. We also have a Forging Bonds coming, or that has already come, depending on when I release this video, so hopefully you guys have enjoyed or will enjoy those Forging Bonds whenever they come. So, New Year's Regin is a cavalry, as you can tell by her Sage Yarn, which is her harmonized, let's say, mount that you see on the model, and she is a Blue Tome, very interesting weapon for the type of unit that you can see on the screen, at least the little sprite. So as I told you, Regin is from Book 5, which is all on the channel if you want to check it out and learn more about her. And well, as usual, we will go through everything that you need to know about Regin, so dialogue, art, etc. Then a build showcase, the new style of the showcases has it with only one build for newest heroes, so that I don't really go overboard in making them. For older heroes or heroes that I really like, I will make more builds. In this case, Regin lacks a B-skill, so I kinda made my own build, I will say as much. But it is technically only one. And then after that we have the gameplay showcase. So, enjoy the first part of the video, I will be back with you after all the first part with the build showcase.
Do you think my brothers will give me New Year's gifts? I can't wait! Wow! Since it's a new year, I fixed up my Gulen Bursty so it's sparkling! This next year, we'll do everything together, right? It'll be the best year ever! Time for my New Year's fortune! Alright, let's see. The worst possible luck. So that huge stack of mochi over there, is that decoration? Or are we going to eat it? It's making me hungry. Happy New Year! Let's make this year just as fun as last year! Even when I'm dressed up, I can't keep the refined act going all that long. Time for my New Year's fortune! Alright, let's see. The worst possible luck.
And here we are with the build showcase. This time, as I told you earlier, we have a Blue Tome Regin, also cavalry once again, and once again with very useful movement effects tied to her weapon. But before we get to that, we have the stats to analyze. So she has a very middling HP, not too much, but also not terrible, but at a level where she is very fragile, so it is a hero that you want to focus on the player phase. Enemy phase, if you aren't careful, you get rushed down very easily. Attack is very high, nearly 60, but it is an asset for me, so I have another bonus to it, which was pretty nice whenever I pulled her. Speed is also pretty decent, we are at 40, by the standard of today it is not as high as the fastest units in the game, but it is still a very good amount of speed. Then we have defenses which are pretty middling, with resistance that is a flow, but is pretty fine, because you don't really want her to fight, you only want her to attack and destroy the enemy. And she is a powerhouse at that. She kinda reminds me of the Valentine Leaf, but without the penalties in a way, because the penalties is tied with how her kit works, and we'll check out why it is in just a second. So as I told you, it is only this build that you see on the right, but I will also tell you some pointers on how to upgrade her if you want the necessary tools. So let's get into it, shall we? We have the base skill set. Let's start with the weapon, which is Nidavellir Lots. So this is a very simple weapon, if you ignore the canto effect, which is only after you attack, assist skill or destruction of a structure, you can move to spaces. So it is attack plus 3, always, you get canto 2, which just explains what it is, you can move to spaces after an action, only for turns from 1 to 3. On turn 4, she gets a special cooldown count minus 3 on herself, and then always, this is an effect that is always, at the start of combat, if she has more than 25% HP, she gets attack and speed plus 6 during combat. So to sum it up, attack plus 3, canto 2 on the first 3 turns, and then after that she gets a special cooldown minus 3 on herself, only on turn 4. And then always she gets attack and speed plus 6 if her HP is higher or equal to 25% during combat. So this is a pretty good, let's say, kit to start with for her, because it gives her an edge in the first 3 turns as an offensive attacker, and then she gets another burst of energy with her special charge. Now you might ask, why is it focused so much around the special? Because she has her own unique special. It is Say Your Shield. At the start of turn 1, she gets special cooldown count minus 3 to herself, so you get another free use at turn 1 and then at turn 4. Hopefully, we can also get it out at turn 2 or 3, depending on the situation. Usually turn 3 seems to be the one more likely, since you double attack on turn 2 and then you double attack on turn 3. But with how high of an attack that she has, probably won't even need to use the special, honestly. This special is insane. Boost damage by 15, so a flat increase of damage always, and calculates the damage using the lower of 4F or S, so the Dragon Adaptive Damage effect. Very nice, but you can see the problem here is the high cost, which is why you get the turn 4 effect over here and the turn 1 effect over here, which kinda make it so that Regin has to guarantee the nukes to destroy any enemy, because of how strong she can get, with such a skill. Then the rest of the kit is pretty simple. As you can tell, you want to focus on attack. So we have a Swift Sparrow 3, extra attack and speed. This, honestly, I wouldn't replace it with anything because it is pretty good by the standard. And then we have Cross Spur Attack. This grants attack plus 5 to allies in cardinal direction to few units during combat. So this is a buffing skill. So generally, you would want to replace this with something like attack and rest menace, speed and rest menace, stuff like that, you should expect. Lowering the rest of the enemy is probably your best gamble in battle, and lowering your own attack and speed as well. So that should be, or rather, rising your own attack and speed, not lowering them. That should be your focus on battle as far as priorities go, for Regin at least. So what you want to replace with Crossbow Attack, as I told you, attack and speed menace, or let's say speed and rest menace, or death and rest menace can also work, because the focus is either on lowering the speed of the enemy or lowering the rest of the enemy. Either of the two work. Attack, you don't really need to lower it. I have in this case Lull attack rest 3. So for the B skill, you have to choose it yourself. She does not come with a B skill. In my case, I went for a lowering rest skill. In this case, it is Lull attack rest. Speed Res would be the best one for obvious reasons, but I only add this one. Very helpful for many reasons, because it denies any buff to Res during combat, which helps a lot with her niche, and also can be kinda useful to make her a little bit tankier when she faces a mage that she doesn't one shot. In terms of seals, you want to go with raw damage if possible, or raw damage and speed. So, death blow, another Swift Sparrow whenever you feel like it is the best choice for her. In this case, I preferred attack. So how does she perform in battle? Well, New Year Regine is a sort of, let's say, better attacker, because she goes into battle, she nukes the enemy at turn 1, she goes back. Then the enemy comes towards you. With your high offenses, you can instantly deny any sort of attacking unit because she's that strong. But you have to be very careful whenever you reach turn 4, because at that point your Kanto will run out, and so she is a little bit more vulnerable. So at the start, very strong, gets a little bit weaker over time, but not to the point where it will impede your run altogether or your fight, whatever you are doing. But for stuff like PvP, I can see Regine being very good, since PvP it is a very instant mode, the first turn decide everything. In stuff that is kinda longer, like trick battles, such as the limited battles, the boss battles, etc., she might need a little bit of a further attention wearing a user, because after turn 4, with no more canto, you need to be very careful. Anyway, this is what Regine brings to the table, a very good unit in my opinion, one that probably you should consider rolling for because of the unique special and style that she brings to the table, and also because I think that the art is kinda cute, at least I like it myself. Other than that, my friends, this is it for the showcase of this specific unit. As I told you, the next one will be Plumeria, also from New Year's, but from last year, not this one. And hopefully I will see you then. Do not worry, we have the gameplay showcase incoming for the last part of this video, and also the Fortune Bonds that have already come or are coming very soon. Thank you very much for watching this Fire Emblem Heroes showcase. Remember to like and subscribe to support the channel. And remember to be next time for the next showcase or anything else of Fire Emblem Heroes that you want to watch. Now, do not leave and enjoy the gameplay showcase.
Salvageable. Well, the new year calls. Your first dream. Let the fireworks begin! Feeling lucky?
Yes?
Who should I prank?
Well, yes, of course. Happy New Year!
I believe in you.
Nice!
You got it! Yeah! Let the fireworks begin! Like so?
Alrighty then!
Well, a New Year's gift! The New Year calls. Your first dream. You got it!